can talk about stereotype and find out some common stereotype in Vietnam. But before that, let's define what is stereotype, bias, prejudice, discrimination, and racism.
According to the course book, Intercultural, Competence, Interpersonal Communication Across Culture by Myron W. Lustig and Jolene Costa, stereotypes are a form of generalization about some group of people. When people stereotype others, they take a category of people and make assessments about the characteristics of all people who belong to that category. Stereotype can be true or not. Bias. According to Cambridge Dictionary, bias is the action of supporting or opposing a particular person or thing in an unfair way because of allowing personal opinion to influence your judgment.
And now we'll move on to the definition of prejudice. Prejudice refers to negative attitudes toward other people that are based on faulty and invisible stereotypes. Prejudice attitudes include irrational feelings of dislike and even hatred for certain groups, biased perceptions and beliefs about the group members that are not based on direct experiences and first-hand knowledge, and a readiness to behave in negative and unjust way toward members of the group. Next is the definition of discrimination. Whereas prejudice refers to people's attitudes or mental representation, the term discrimination refers to behavioral manifestation of that prejudice. Thus, discrimination can be thought of as prejudice in action. Finally, is racism. The word racism itself can evoke very powerful emotional reactions, especially for those who have felt oppression and exploitation that stem from racist attitudes and behaviors. For members of African American, Asian American, Native American and Latino cultures, racism has created a social history shaped by prejudice and discrimination. For individual members of C groups, racism has resulted in the pain of oppression.
And now let us explore three common stereotypes in Vietnam. Firstly, turtle is bad.
According to the website kidshealth.org, a turtle is a pronounced kind of body art, a design emitted by puncturing the skin with needles and injecting inks, dyes, and pigment into the deep layer of the skin. According to many websites in the internet, talk about turtles. Many Vietnamese people believe that a person with tattoo is a body in bad, especially with women. They also believe that tattoos are the size of a crime. The concept of tattooing is unacceptable, or who tattoo is often not reliable, still exists from family to society and office relationship. They assume that only bad person get tattoo. Xăm mình không xấu, nhưng người xấu mới xăm mình. So where did the cause of this stereotype come from? Let's find out it. According to the website southstar.vn, the cause of this stereotype stems from around the 19th century when criminals often operated in gangs. Each gang had its own tattoo. Since then, many people believe that tattoos are a sign that identify criminals. In Vietnam, the tool has been an identity since ancient history, but in the decades 1970 and 1980, the tool culture began to emerge, popular mainly among the gangster and criminal. Tattoos are here as a way of expressing class and asserting oneself. Tattoos play a role and meaning to show power, while enhancing the ability to oppress others. The facts also show that many criminals are people with tattoos in their body, which increase the validity of this stereotype, leading many people to believe that tattoos are bad. Therefore, tattoos invisibly associates with the image of the Turk, criminal gangs, and prostitutes. These are considered the main reason for stereotypes about tattoos in general and tattooists in particular.
That viewpoint is not true to the current societies. I agree that bad guys can get tattoos, but people with tattoos are not necessarily bad.
Recently, netizens are buzzing about the story of a tattoo artist who won the Rap Việt champion with his tattoo all over his body. According to VN Express website, there are many mixed opinions given. As we can be seen, there are still some people who can have a prejudice. That's why a tattoo person can win the championship such a big competition, which will make young people imitate. But we should have an objective and fair view of tattoo people. I learned the following information from Tattoo magazine. Tattoo are also an art worth cherishing because they all have their own meanings associated with certain memories. Someone tattoo not to express their own ego or personality, but they can be an indescribable pain or even more desire and ambition of each individual. According to an article in the newspaper, tattoo shop owner said that there are many people coming to tattoo now. Customers are usually in the age range from 20 to 50 years old. Most of them are government officials, successful businessmen. Many people consider tattoo a normal jewelry with small features such as flower, clover, cranes. It's like to attract other people. In addition, tattoos are also to keep the memories, an important milestone in life, or in desire to conceal physical defects such as scars, birthmarks, trademarks. People tattoo to show their belief and devotion to the religion they follow. Other websites like Good.vn and VTV 24 Hours News channel have the same opinion as above. Vietnamese people have a saying, "Đừng nhìn mặt mà bắt hình xăm," which means don't judge a book by its cover. We should not judge a person just by their appearance. Tattoo people are good citizens. They still live and work hard. They are even very successful. Tattoo has a certain meaning. Only when you open your heart to listen, you will understand that person. Do not just either talk tattoo on the body, because they do not determine the worth of a person.
Recently, the European Police Agency has released a report that China is increasingly emerging as a hub for production of the counterfeit goods. The largest counterfeit goods for sale worldwide. They gave a startling number. China and Hong Kong generate 86% of the fake goods in the world, earn nearly 400 billion USD in 2015. To be more precise, 3,965 USD. Everything is colorful by color, from simple to batteries, from watch to electronic, from designer clothes to toys, from medicine to food to cigarettes. You can see many kind of famous brands and counterfeit of China. Instead of Zara, you can see here Zara or S&M has become S&M. In any country in the world, people are overwhelmed by the arrival of Chinese goods. They are sold greatly all over the market, eye-catching design and surprisingly cheap price. But the quality is really very. Several US surveys over the past few years have found toxic substances on Chinese clothing, such as lead, nanophenol, phthalate, phthalate, formaldehyde. In particular, it had a tie of half, but collectively, it's essential, undercurrent, discordant, allergic inflammation, reproductive effect. In recent years, wood ordering from China has been overwhelming and popular in the line of Vietnamese customers. And since then, a series of articles about Chinese products causing cancer, Chinese toys are upheaval, gradually appearing more and more. However, because of economic profits, many people have checked smuggled goods with unknown origin to Vietnam. Therefore, the quality of the goods is not guaranteed, and when it comes to Chinese products, people often associate with fake and poor quality goods.
Ui, cái này đều quá, hàng Trung Quốc đây mà.
Okay, we have seen very clearly in Biden that Chinese goods are not good, right? If I just look at the inviting, as some people say, maybe I will boycott Chinese goods too. But all Chinese goods are completely bad. My name is Mati Chan. Now, let me find out this.
You may not know, all the Chinese goods we use are Chinese export. When you learn about Chinese export, you can see that there are high-end products and low-end products. But whatever goods have in common is that the quality is guaranteed to be acceptable and must be inspected before entering foreign market, including Vietnam. According to Tiểu Thần Đài website, this is an example of Tiểu Thần Đài's quality control process. We can see the quality control process of the entire customer purchasing process, starting from the moment the customer purchases the order until it reaches the customer. Maintaining a strict and consistent process helps us to ensure quality service throughout, thereby building confidence in the quality of Chinese goods. When it comes to top quality products from China, we cannot mention famous phone brands such as Apple, Huawei, Xiaomi. There are also top brands all over the world.
According to VN Express Global Smartphone Market Report, China has 3 out of the 5 largest mobile phone companies in the world. That is to say, Chinese electronics are good and smart. In addition, Chinese products such as shoes, gloves, bags are always welcome, mainly young Vietnamese. They are very diverse in size, design as well as quality, where the likes are the good in the world. Some Chinese goods are divided into many categories, mainly in gurus, high-end goods, mid-range, and low-end products. It meets the need of both beautiful and reasonable price. Along with that, there are many other Chinese products that are very good, such as household goods, herbal medicines, snacks. Okay, let me take an example from some items in my family's. Simply as this tag a post, my mother bought it for 99,000 dong. Up to now, it has been used for 3 years, but still beautiful and durable. This pair of cotton sandals we used in winter. I bought for only 100,000 dong out of 5 pairs. It was just warm and comfortable. Because of many Chinese products are good, according to Greens of Vietnam website, they point out top 10 big websites ordering China goods such as Taobao, Tmall, Alibaba, AliExpress, Ting, so on. There's no denying that part of Chinese products is really poor quality. However, the reality is that the vast majority of Chinese goods are of good quality, commensurate with their affordable price. Hence, we should objectively accept the Chinese goods stereotype.
Hi everyone, I'm Ngân. Today I will introduce stereotype cohabitation. Let's start.
Cohabitation in an arrangement where two people are not married but live together. They are often involved in the romantic or society or sexually intimate relationship on a long-term or permanent basis. Such arrangements have become increasingly common in Vietnam countries since the late 12th century, being led by training survival, especially regarding marriage, gender, role, and religion. The late social prejudice in terms of traditional etching and fine custom of Vietnam. Cohabitation in a broad base lifestyle. According in it, it is essential of young people to reach a doctor to marry. The opinion of the unmarried group so that the marriage trend is still the main trend in the future. With 80.5% of the unmarried people reporting that they will be married. 46.2% say that adolescent must get married.
Like the sale of USA adults who are casually married has declined modestly in recent decades from 58% in 1995 to 53% today. Over the same period, the sale of adults who are lives with an unmarried person has risen from 3% to 7%.
Less the cost of cohabiting. There are many cohabiting of which there are three main cause. Firstly, cause yourself because of living away from home, lack of affection, lack of a mother, or maybe because of demanding. Secondly, call from family because person are not family, say their daily disturbing season, cutting, cursing, and quarreling in the family are factors that make young people not want to think about marrying. Finally, call from society. Due to the influence of winter culture, the seafood situation in of having sex and cohabiting for marriage is an alarming leap.
Hi everyone, my name is Hua. What I'd like to present to you today is cohabitation. Today I'm going to talk about the benefit of living together before getting married. So you live together before marriage. Now follow me.
Chờ xa thiệt là xa, cá mắm em bán xong lại còn đám đang diệt nhà. Không bao đồng lo chuyện người ta, không là cả tấm bái tấm ba. Nào có ai thương tôi như bà xã? Lối xóm ai cũng thương hay thường khen tặng vợ.
We were both young when I first saw you. I closed my eyes and the flashback starts.
Cohabitation have probably become family among today's young people, especially students. One of the hot issues is of great consent to married people. Other reason for the increase on the cohabitation rate are more practical. For example, couple often says the economic benefits sharing rent, utility, furniture, as a motivation for moving in together. Martins believes that because living together gives you the opportunity to get to know one another better, to make a more informed decision regarding marriage. Currently, students and young people live away from their family tend to live with their loves to cultivate feeling and share resource of study and work, economy, or simply to learn about the other party to avoid the rosemary. Living between a man and a woman before marriage can make both people feel more responsible for their family. So, there is a clear division of labor in the house. For example, the cost of living before marriage, such as rent, clothing, food, housing, travels, can bring more pressure on a man. It's a way a family's origins when they would already take responsibility for the past, and women will also change, no longer be picky, lose their temper, but begin to learn to be children, sorry, learn to be diligent and fruitful. It's a good stepping stone to marry.
Hey guys, we had talked about the definitions of stereotype, bias, prejudice, discrimination, and racism, and three common stereotypes in Vietnam. Through this project, we learned a better understanding about the stereotypes and the importance of challenge stereotype. I learned this information from the chapter 6 of the coursebook, Intercultural, Competence in the Personal Communication Across Culture, about the importance of challenge stereotype. We challenge stereotype to minimize the negative effects of prejudice and discrimination. We also challenge to function competently in a world that's increasingly characterized by multiple cultural inhabiting accents and often overlapping terrain, to maintain positive, healthy relationship with people from cultures other than your own, is a hallmark of intercultural individuals.